China extended its crackdown in Hong Kong today, arresting a prominent pro-democracy activist and media owner. As Nick Schifrin tells us, it comes as the highest-level American official in decades visited Taiwan to reinforce U.S. ties to the island in defiance of Beijing.
For Beijing, this is what protecting national security looks like, frog-marching a media tycoon through his own newsroom, plainclothes officers rifling through reporters' papers, and hundreds of police corralling journalists and arresting editors who produce journalism critical of the Chinese Communist Party, or CCP. Apple Daily is Hong Kong's largest media outlet, and its owner Jimmy Lai, an outspoken advocate for democracy, whose arrest was designed to silence a Hong Kong media that until now enjoyed freedoms that don't exist in mainland China, says senior aide Mark Simon.
We take a strong stand for pro-democracy. We don't make any bones about it. Our media is starting to look more like the mainland than Hong Kong of the past.
Many of Hong Kong's freedoms are stifled by Beijing's new national security law. Lai and activist 23-year-old Agnes Chow were both arrested for, quote, colluding with foreign powers, punishable with life in prison. And the law is written so vaguely, pro-democracy advocates fear it can be used against any critics anywhere.
That law will mean exactly what they want it to mean, when they want it to mean it, and when they need to use it. It will also be used if a young college student from Hong Kong stands up at UCLA and starts talking about how much they love democracy and freedom. This is a widespread and an overreaching law that has incredibly draconian implications.
Beijing says it's protecting Hong Kong from protesters who last year turned violent. And last week, Chief Administrator Carrie Lam says because of COVID, upcoming elections that pro-democracy candidates were expected to win had to be postponed until next year. In response, the U.S. imposed sanctions on Lam and 10 other Hong Kong officials and called the national security law a tool for CCP repression. Today, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs called that proof that the U.S. was biased against China.
Current U.S. policy towards China is a strategic mistake, based on a lack of truth and evidence, venting emotions, and McCarthyist bias.
And Beijing announced its own sanctions on 6 Republican lawmakers and 5 leaders of NGOs critical of Beijing, including National Democratic Institute President Derek Mitchell.
It's part and parcel of today's China, where it's not just about what happens in China, but around the world that they want people to be quiet about what's really happening. They don't care about law. They don't care about truth. They don't care about abiding by the basic law of Hong Kong.
Last year, Mitchell spoke in Hong Kong and has co-written 3 books about China. He argues under Xi Jinping, the Chinese Communist Party is willing to try and silence domestic and international critics no matter the consequence.
They're going to use their power and that they will not accept anything that is remotely rights-based or democracy-based in Hong Kong and keep going until they feel it is squashed entirely. It's very, very sad. We're seeing in our headlines on a daily basis in broad daylight. And it doesn't stop in Hong Kong. We have to recognize that. It can certainly move to the free people of Taiwan.
The fear that Taiwan is next is the backdrop for the highest-ranking U.S. visit in 4 decades. Secretary of Health and Human Services Alex Azar gave a show of support to President Tsai Ing-wen, considered a Beijing critic.
It's a true honor to be here to convey a message of strong support and friendship from President Trump to Taiwan.
Officially, Azar is visiting because Taiwan's a COVID success story, in stark contrast to the U.S. Taiwan's had fewer than 500 cases thanks to quick actions in January, like widespread testing and tracing and mandatory masks. But Beijing considers Taiwan a breakaway province, and U.S. support, especially military support, as meddling in internal affairs. During Azar's visit, the nationalist tabloid Global Times reported Chinese planes entered Taiwanese airspace as a clear message. And the clear message received in Hong Kong by the national security law, activists, residents, even business people are now considering leaving.
Information is everything. And this law is telling, especially the financial community, there are certain pieces of information that we're not going to let you have. The ripple effect is going to be significant. It is not just one more cut in the grain here. This is like an axe chop.
Today, after the raid, Apple Daily vowed to continue its work. But it acknowledged that in Hong Kong today, press freedom is hanging by a thread. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.